TriniGirlNatural. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm highlighting a small business, Marlene Natural Beauty Secrets. Definitely check it out if you're curious about her hair and body products. She did kindly send me a few items to try. I tried the hair items and this is the result. I got a nice big fluffy hair wig, which I love. So it didn't say wash and go, but I hadn't done a wash and go in a long time, so I really wanted to do one. So I took the opportunity to get me a nice big hair day, which I love to rock, as you guys know. So let's get into the demo and I'll come back with the review. So this is my hair before any product. And I'm starting off with the moisturizing detangler. So my one issue with this is it's pretty runny. So I wish it was like in a spray bottle, but if I just put it in my hands and rub my palms together, I can manage. I'm just used to going directly from hand to hair. And I have to do this rub step first because it's pretty runny. This is it in my hands. I like how it feels on my hair. So this is with the detangler. This side of course has the detangler and cream. This is with the detangler. So far so good. And now I'm going to add the cream. So this one is the hair styling cream. I love this so far. Nice texture, no need to worry about it running. Nice texture. I do like the slip on this one as well. I love the scent on both of them. They're like sweetest scents, which I like. I wish I could describe it better, but it's sweet. It could be kind of vanilla-y maybe, like a sweet vanilla-ish type scent, but it's nice. And this is it. All the product is in. It's light and fluffy, but still defined, as you can see. So I'm just looking forward to seeing when it dries, and I guess you are too. So take a look. Yeah, and this is the result. It's like super light, super fluffy, lots of movement. My hair looked really great after I applied the product. It was just so big that I knew it was gonna turn into a big hair day. Like if my hair was bigger after applying product than before, but it's still like defined and so on, I know it's just gonna be a big fluffy wash and go. So you ain't gonna see me complaining, I love that. I was like so excited, I was all over Instagram like, yay, big hair week. But yeah, it turned out good. So this is the result. You can see it's defined, but a little frizzy and big. So I like that it has a little bit of hole, which means that I can rock this. I can rock this for a few days. It's not gonna be like a one and done type of big wash and go. Cause sometimes when you, like if you just do a leave-in, depending on the leave-in, some leave-ins I can get like 4 days out of, but depending on the leave-in, I may not get that hole. But I like that it looks like I just have leave-in in my hair, but it also has a bit of hole, so I'll get a few days out of it. I love the shape. I haven't had the shape in a long time. I love the movement. I love that it's not crunchy. So I wish that it had a little bit more moisture, but overall, I like it and I like that it's gonna last me a couple days. So I used her moisturizing detangler 2 and her hair styling cream 2, and my hair was just super light and fluffy after applying these products. The slip on both were nice and both smell amazing, so yay for that. And I actually like putting my hands in my hair, so yay for that, because that's kind of one of my tests. The one thing I would say about it is that I wish that it had a little bit more moisture. The moisturizing detangler probably should have been in a spray bottle given how runny it is, just to make it easier to put into the hair. And just like as a spray, I think this would be moisturizing, really moisturizing for a spray leave-in. But for a lotion leave-in, I wish it had a little bit more moisture. The cream I actually liked. I really liked the texture, I liked how it went on, and I felt like it moisturized my hair. And it does have hole, like I said, and it's an interesting kind of stretchy hole, not a crunchy hole, which I like. At least my hair doesn't feel like bricks. I can't say it added much shine, but I think it didn't take away any shine either. I do think my hair looks relatively shiny. My hair is naturally shiny, but I can see some shine. It says it's great for flexi rods, perm rods, twist outs, and ponytails. So it didn't really say wash and go, but I just really wanted to try a wash and go. I was thinking about leaving it for the summer since I wanted to do like a big hair wash and go, but I was too curious. I had to get into it, so I decided to just do it now and have a little summer wash and go in the spring. So here we are. Of course, if I'm trying it, you know the ingredients are good, but I really like the ingredients. Let me show you. Kind of have to go around the bottle, I guess. My hair needs water with the aloe, don't get it twisted, so... But people who love aloe vera juice, definitely give it a try. And of course the rose and hibiscus, you know I love those ingredients. Peppermint, of course, peppermint and mint. Basil even, great for the scalp. So I was happy to see those as well. And you know, coconut oil, almond butter, shea butter, sage, bay leaf, honey, agave. Like the ingredients are really good, it even has bamboo extract in here, so... Yay for the ingredients. I think cherry vanilla is the closest to what I would say it smells like, but I love the scent. It's like a kind of custardy, creamy cherry vanilla scent. Even though it was very liquid, it was still creamy, so I did like it, and I just wish it was a little bit thicker or in a spray bottle. And this one, the ingredients are really pretty similar. There are a few differences. I was surprised to see xanthan gum more in this one and not in this one, because I like xanthan gum in my stylers. But this also has flaxseed, so I was like, okay, it's good. And of course, you know me on flaxseed. Flaxseed usually gives me crunch, but there's no crunch, so yay for that. So I guess it's just a touch of flaxseed, not too much, a good amount, let's put it that way. So I was happy with that. It provided a good amount of hold, so if you're looking for a cream with hold, definitely give this a try. And it works in pretty well. Like if I can put it in my dry hair and get it to go in, that means it absorbs pretty well. So both of these products absorb well on my low porosity hair, so yay for that as well. So this one smells slightly more buttery, like a buttery version of the cherry vanilla, but it's still in that sweet, milky-ish custardy scent, which I like. I think overall I'd be willing to use both again, but this one would be like if I want big hair or if I want to try it in a twist out or something. This one, as it is, I'd probably use it as a leave-in and then put a heavier cream over it. Together, I would say I would like a little more moisture, so I would add something else to give it a little bit more moisture. But that's the only thing I would say. The slip was good, I love how it smells, and I love the result. And she also sent me this honey lemon body balm, which smelled really good and worked really nicely on my skin. I'll demo this as well. Guess I can put it higher up so you see that. For me, I like it on wet skin just because it feels almost like a sealant. So I like it kind of sealing in water or sealing in moisture. So it starts with shea butter as the first ingredient. So it's definitely more of a sealant for my skin because you know my skin is low porosity too. But it also does have some honey in there and hibiscus. The scent is honey lemon. I want to say it smells like ginger or something. I love the scent. It smells like those lemon cookies. I just absolutely love it. This is what it looks like. So it's just a yummy looking light butter. So it's not whipped exactly. It's not heavy, but it's not like super fluffy. It just reminds me of butter. Like if you have butter and regular butter out of the fridge and it's just, you know. Let me show you. So it absorbs really well. Feels really good on your skin. Moisturizes really well. And what I like about this too, like using it on my hands, usually if I'm using a more natural product and I use it on my hands, if I wash my hands once, my hands are dry again, but this, I can use it just once for the day and it actually sticks around on my hands. So I've been using it after the shower and just after washing my hands to keep my skin moisturized and smelling amazing. So I think I'd have to say the body balm is probably my favorite product of the three. I would definitely use this leave-in again if it came in a spray or was a little bit thicker. And I would also use this styling cream again. I just don't think I would put them together because this needed a little bit more. I guess they both needed more moisture. So yeah, I'll probably have to use something more moisturizing with them. But overall, definitely no complaints. And I liked using them. I definitely encourage you to check out her website and follow her on Instagram and stuff like that. I'll be doing that just to see what else she comes up with and like, you know, try some of her stuff because like I said, the ingredients are really good. I'm glad to be like your eye in the sky. I'm glad to be bringing you little sneak peeks of the new and upcoming products. Let me know if you're one of those looking out for small businesses. Are you on Etsy? Like, I'm on Etsy a lot, just checking them out. PJ Problems, yeah, but I love products. I love all products. Bring them all to me. See you in the next one. Bye.